Hello students, this is Swati Zade. So we are going to discuss our unit of applied electronics, second unit, that is high power amplifier. So in the first lecture we have discussed the introduction of high power amplifier. In that first lecture we have discussed what is high power amplifier, its different features and applications of that high power amplifier. So in this lecture we are going to discuss the classification of high power amplifier. Now the high power amplifier or power amplifier, they are classified as a class A power amplifier, class B power amplifier or class AB power amplifier and class C power amplifier. Now class A power amplifier, class B, class AB and class C power amplifier. This classification of the power amplifier, it is based on the position of the cue point. That is, first type is class A. In class A the cue point, that is this position of the cue point, it is located in the middle of the load line, means your transistor is conducting for 360 degrees. This is class A power amplifier. In case of class B power amplifier, the cue point is adjusted or located in the cutoff region, means your transistor is conducting only for the 180 degrees. In case of class AB power amplifier, the cue point is adjusted, said just above the cutoff region. It is just above the cutoff region. It means the transistor will conduct, that is, more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. And the last type is class C power amplifier. In case of class C power amplifier, the cue point is set below the cutoff region, means your transistor will conduct for less than 180 degree. So these are the classification of class A, class B, class AB and class C power amplifier on the basis of position of the cue point. So next we will discuss one by one. So first is class A power amplifier. In case of class A power amplifier, just we have discussed the cue point, it is adjusted or it is set near the or in the middle of the DC load line. This is the output characteristics of the transistor. In the output, that is output characteristics is plotted in between output voltage VCE and output current IC, and this is the DC load line and this cue point is adjusted just in the middle of the DC load line. This is class A power amplifier. Now since the cue point is adjusted in the center of the DC load line, your transistor, means we will bias the transistor in such a way that cue point will be adjusted in the center of the DC load line like this. So therefore whenever the AC signal is applied to the base of the transistor, the, that is base current, your transistor will conduct for complete positive half cycle and for complete negative half cycle, means your transistor or amplifier, it will conduct for full 360 degrees. Since we have adjusted the cue point in at the middle of the load line and your transistor amplifier will conduct completely for 360 degrees. This is the class A power amplifier. Now the we will discuss some advantage and disadvantage also. That is, since the transistor, it is conducting for complete 360 degree, there is no distortion. means you output waveform, it will be clear, or we get the output waveform completely for 360 degree, means no distortion is there, but the transistor is continuously operated in the active region, means continuously the collector current will flow in the transistor, and therefore means large current will flow in the transistor, and due to that power get dissipated in the form of heat, and due to that power dissipation power losses are there, and therefore the efficiency of this class A power amplifier, it will be very low among all types of power amplifier. This is the class A power amplifier. Second is the class B power amplifier. Now in case of class B power amplifier, the Q point, it is adjusted in the cutoff region, or we can say that on the x-axis. So due to this, means Q point is adjusted on the x-axis, or we can say that this is the cutoff region. So therefore for positive half cycle the transistor will be conducting, and for negative half cycle your transistor will not conducting, since the Q point is adjusted in the cutoff region. Means during positive half cycle this transistor will enter into the active mode and your transistor will be conducting, your amplifier will be conducting, and for negative half cycle your transistor will be in cutoff mode and it will not conduct, and therefore for positive half cycle we are getting the positive, but for negative half cycle we are not getting any waveform. So therefore this, the main drawback of this type of class B power amplifier is that distortion is there. This is the one drawback. But since the transistor, it is operated only for 180 degree, means power losses becomes less, and therefore efficiency of this type of amplifier, it is higher than the class A. The efficiency of this class B is greater than the class A, but distortion is higher than the class A type of power amplifier. Next is the class AB power amplifier. In case of class AB power amplifier, the Q point is adjusted just above the cutoff region. Means your transistor is just enter into the active mode. So this is the Q point. Now due to this, means since the Q point is just shifted above the your cutoff region, the transistor will conduct more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. So therefore in this case the distortion becomes less than class B, but the efficiency is more than efficiency of this type of class, or efficiency of class AB amplifier, it is greater than A but less than B, and distortion is greater than B but less than A. That is, this is the class AB power amplifier. And last is class C power amplifier. In case of class C power amplifier, the Q point is adjusted below the cutoff region, or below the x-axis, and therefore your transistor will conduct for less than 180 degree. It means the distortion is more, but the efficiency get increases, and it is highest in all type of power amplifier. So this is your class C power amplifier, and we will now compare the class A, class B, class AB and class C power amplifier on the basis of these different types of parameter. So first parameter is, that is collector current waveform. We will discuss this parameter from the next slide. That is, in case of class A power amplifier, the conduction angle is 360 degree, means the Q point is adjusted at the middle of the DC load line. Therefore, the output waveform we get complete for 360 degree. In case of class B power amplifier, the conduction angle is 180 degree and therefore we get the output waveform only for 180 degree. Conduction angle is 180 degree. In case of class AB power amplifier, the Q point is adjusted just above the X axis and therefore conduction angle is more than 180 degree but less than 360 degree. In case of class C power amplifier, the Q point is adjusted just below the X axis, therefore conduction angle is less than 180 degree. So these are the waveform, that is in case of class A, class B, class AB and class C. After that, conduction angle. So conduction angle for class A is 360 degree, for class B it is 180 degree, for class AB greater than 180 but less than 360, and for class C it is less than 180 degree. Then position of Q point. So in case of class A it is at the center, for class B it is on the X axis, for class AB it is just above the X axis, and for class C it is below the X axis. And then distortion in the output. So in class A, since the conduction angle is 360 degree, no distortion is there. For class B it is, conduction angle is 180 degree, means more than the class A distortion is there. We get only waveform, output waveform for only for half cycle. Then for class AB it is low, means it, we get the waveform more than B but less than A, since the conduction angle is in between 180 and 360. And in case of class C, distortion is very very high, since the conduction angle is less than 180 degree. And last, then efficiency. The efficiency of class A power amplifier, it is very low and it is only 25%. In case of class B, again if the efficiency is greater than A, it is near about 78.5%. In case of class AB, it is greater than A but less than B, means in between 50 to 78.5%. and the efficiency of class C power amplifier, it is the highest efficiency and it is about 95%. And the last point is the power dissipation. Since the class A power amplifier, it conducts for 360 degree, the power dissipation is very high. Then the AB, the conduction angle is in between 180 and 360, therefore the power dissipation is moderate. After that, the for class B power amplifier, conduction angle is 180 degree, therefore power dissipation is low. Low means below, means low than AB. And then class C, the conduction angle is very, means less than 180 degree, so the power dissipation is lowest among all the power amplifier. It is very low. This is the comparison of class A, class B, class AB and class C power amplifier on the basis of this, all these parameters. This is the comparison. And so in this video we have discussed the classification types of power amplifier as a class A, class B, class AB and class C. And again we have discussed the comparison of all these four types of power amplifier on the basis of different parameters. So in this, means on this topic, the question may ask, compare class A, class B, class AB and class C type of power amplifier. Comparison, the question may ask on the comparison of all these type of, all the four types of power amplifier on the basis of these parameters. So thank you.